In this video, I will attempt to show why I disagree with researcher Stephen Mailer in regards to what is depicted in Dendera, Egypt regarding the so-called light bulbs. My task is quite difficult because I'm dealing with the world of the occult and the etheric. But nonetheless, let's look at that footage and then I will proceed on.
It's being shown. You can touch it, but here, the giants here are the ancient Cremations. They're being painted as giants. Now, we say to people, is it symbolic or is it actual? Why does it have to be either or? Why can it not be both? They could have been giants, but giants of mind.
Uh-huh.
Okay, depicted. Showing here what obviously Chris first pointed this out in 1998 in the Giza power plant, this is a crook's tomb, obviously. Again, some people will say, and I won't mention names, that this is just symbolic. Why does it have to be both? This shows a knowledge of electricity that was there. Why, if it's symbolic, do you have a wire being plugged into a box?
I thought that was...
Of course. Yeah. And this is the backbone of Osiris.
Ah.
The Jed pillar. Jed pillar. Where they come to the name, used in Arabic today in Egypt, Jeddah means grandpa. Hakim was always called Jeddah. Jed pillar. But what it is, the backbone of Osiris Opus represents the spinal column. Electricity being produced. This is producing electricity. Clearly.
So if we see that elsewhere, that's the backbone.
That's the Jed pillar. I'll point it out, the Jed pillar.
Yes.
Now, to finish it, you have to go against the wall to see the final scene.
Wait, sorry.
Go ahead. You'll get time to take the picture.
Oh, yes, I will.
Okay, yes. As soon as we're done.
Sorry, I don't want to
next scene.
We just want to finish the story.
Yeah.
Again, giants, Cremations, the same thing. But here, the beam, and again, the snake is always kundalini energy, always electricity. The beam is being deflected. Why is it being, he's holding up these knives. This creature, argument, it's always an argument what this creature is. Hakim said this is the baboon, the companion of Jehoti, Toth, and it's a symbol of wisdom. But Hank Wesselman, who came with me, who was an anthropologist, said, no, that baboons don't have tails like this. He thought it was a reptile. Whatever it is, whatever you want to think. But it is a creature, and Hakim would say, it is the texts that tell us what's happening here. The texts say that this is a knowledge of credible energy and wisdom that can be abused.
Ah.
This is the origin of the myth of Atlantis right here, folks, from the old kingdom of Egypt, saying that the ancient people had a great knowledge, a great technology that could be abused in modern times. This is a warning to the dynastic people from the ancient Cremations, but first written in the modern script, that great knowledge was known, a great wisdom can be abused. That's the warning. And here he's showing the knowledge of, he's got under control with both hands, snake, staff, they had the knowledge of electricity, clearly. Mm. Anybody can argue symbolic all they want. Mm. This shows they had an actual practical knowledge of electricity.
So with the two knives that are being held, could it be symbolic of one can cut and make you bleed and the other can cut and be of use? So either it's of use or it's of abuse.
Very good, because Hakim would totally agree with that. Everything's in polarities, everything's in duality, and he's using both hands.
Right.
Exactly. But the text warns against the abuse of this knowledge.
Wow.
First up, I'd just like to say that the video was taken by researcher Brian Forrester, and I'm deeply thankful for his work, as well as people like Stephen Mailer also. Although I really dislike the way that Stephen Mailer runs his hands all over that, what I regard as precious Egyptian artwork.
This shows a knowledge of electricity that was there. Why, if it's symbolic, do you have a wire being plugged into a box?
I thought that was...
Of course.
If the lotus stem represents electrical wire going into a box, and let's say that box is a battery or something, or a powering device, then why are people standing on that lotus stem or that wire? And why is the Djed pillar also resting on it? If we look at the depiction beside this depiction of the light bulb, the next one, we can see that the stem just goes down into the base there. Now, there are other depictions of the stem going into the base, where the base perhaps represents the element of water, the energies of water. Anyway, is this really glass we're seeing joined to the lotus? Look where it joins. Are we really talking about glass fitting onto a lotus? And look at the serpents. I agree with Stephen Mailer in this respect, that the serpents represent kundalini energy, shall we say. The serpents don't go into the lotus. or not in every case. So how can that be an electrical wire if it's just sort of floating in the air? Look at this picture also. Within close proximity to the so-called depictions of light bulbs in Dendera, Egypt, you have this depiction of a serpent. Now, some would regard this as the filament of the light bulb emanating up out of the lotus. But where's the bulb in this case? Why is it not depicted? If it's a light bulb, where's the glass? Why would they leave the glass out? Another thing to notice is that it rests on a boat also, and I would suggest that this is representative of astral travel. But anyway, another thing to consider is that the figures around the light bulb have their head touching the light bulb in various ways. And I would suggest that this is to do with spirit orbs and entities with connections via that and the chakras and via the sort of etheric, magnetic, etheric energy pathways of the body. And this includes the hands also. If these are light bulbs, why would two of these great big bulbs be pointing together? And why would the heads of people be connecting with these hot light bulbs? Hot electrical light bulbs? What? And why aren't there depictions of people doing things and working within the light? From Egypt, from the treasures of Tutankhamun's tomb, from the second outermost shrine, you can see a depiction of the serpent. And just as we see in Dendera, we have a field, I would suggest, around the serpent. In this case, it's the Ouroboros, the serpent eating its tail. You also see depictions of humans and animals and serpents emanating from the lotus or the lily. And I would suggest that this is indicative of astral travel. Even Coca-Cola's into it. Check this image out. You have the figure standing in what is a kind of a bulb, it looks like. I would suggest it's a field, and you do have light emanating from it. Freemasons, for example, want more light. They look for more light. And this is to do with the further dimensions, and this is to do with being within the ritual edifice also, because they practice magic just like the ancient Egyptians did. And the tradition has carried on to this day. It's taught within the secretive societies. It's not taught at high schools and universities and all the rest of it, even though it's, say, depicted on the walls of universities, for example. It's depicted everywhere, but the general public remains out of the loop, basically. So you have Egypt, you have the many energies that are depicted around within the walls of Egypt there. You have people, you have the pillars in Egypt. The pillars are pillars of light. So you have that light coming out of the lotus. It is light, but it's etheric light. It's not a glass and a light bulb. And yes, everything's electromagnetic. That's the occult way of seeing the viewing the universe, if you will, among other factors such as the four elements and the spirit. And then you have the ongoing spirit entities and other dimensions, etc. And occultists travel into these, if you will. You have the Lotus Temple in Virginia, and you have the beam of light going out of the lotus there. But that beam of light represents an etheric beam of light. And you would have the serpents also, that energy going up that beam of light up and down, I would suggest. And by the way, of course I'm aware of the Baghdad Battery and the notion that ancient cultures might have had high technology. Absolutely. But what we're dealing with here is symbolism. It's actually quite worldwide, the symbolism. and it's regarding magic. All the best. Bye for now. Thank you.